please get your test out. And let's go ahead and go through that. Number one, for A, we have logistic growth. And you should have said something about growth that is limited by the resources. Okay? Something about that. You could have even said limited by the lack of dead cow. Anyway, plasmids, something about an extra piece of DNA in a bacteria. It's a circular piece, but it was an extra piece. Endospore was what the bacteria puts around its genetic material when there's bad things happening so that it can survive, right? So something about that to protect the genetic material with hard layers or something. Okay, then on number 2 through 5, you're to identify the parts. 2 would be fimbria or fimbriae, however you say it, depending on if you want singular or plural. You could have put pili or pilus. It was much easier to spell. Anyway, number 3 would be the flagellum. Number 4 is the plasma membrane, and number 5 is the DNA. Did anybody get anything else for number 4? Okay, we're good. Did you put cell wall? Give it half. Okay.
I put cell membrane.
That's fine. I'll take that. Okay, number 6. A bacterium suddenly cannot manufacture proteins. What component of the cell is not working?
Ribosomes.
You got to think protein factories. Remember that. The ribosomes are the protein factories. And you're going to need to know that for the rest of the class, because that one's going to come up when we're studying eukaryotic cells too. Okay? Okay, number 7. If a bacterium is anaerobic, would you expect to find it floating on the top of the lake or deep in the muck at the bottom of the lake? I'm sorry? Deep in the muck, right. The anaerobes are the stinky ones. Okay. Number 8. A bacterium is photosynthetic. Is it a decomposer?
Yes.
No.
If it's photosynthetic, it's an autotrophic bacteria. So a decomposer would be a heterotrophic bacteria. Okay. Number 9. A bacterium receives a new trait that it did not previously have. However, it did not participate in conjugation. How is this possible? 2 answers.
Transformation or transduction.
Very good. Transformation or transduction. You only had to have one of those answers. Okay? But either one is acceptable. Somebody come up with anything else? Okay, good. Just wondering. Number 10, what bacterial process does the following schematic represent?
Asexual reproduction.
Good. Asexual reproduction. You could have put binary fission if you're being real technical. Anyway, one of those. Number 11, if a sample of food is dehydrated, what condition for bacterial growth are you removing from the food?
Moisture.
Number 12, if a population of bacteria is in steady state, what does that mean no bacteria are dying?
No.
And then, you know, it didn't say explain. So all you had to say was no. So pretty easy, huh? 2 letters. Number 13, what shape is a bacterium from the genus Streptobacilli or Bacillus?
Rod-shaped
or bat-shaped, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Number 14, a population is composed of bacteria that are very light, sensitive to light. They live in a lake that is in a cave, so they flourish. Slowly, however, a hole begins to erode in the cave's roof. As the days pass, light begins to filter in and the cave starts to be dimly lit. The bacteria begin to die. While the erosion is taking place, however, 2 individual bacteria in the soil above ground fall into the lake. These bacteria cannot survive in the dimness of the poorly lit cave, so they die immediately. Days later, the hole has opened up so that light floods the cavern. Nevertheless, the bacteria that were once dying are flourishing with a population larger than they had before the erosion. Explain how this could happen. You need to explain there that in the process of transformation, a dead bacteria loses its information, then live bacteria can grab it. So you had to say something about that. You could say transformation, because that tells how they got. Do you guys know why this happened? When the guys fell in from the top and died, they had the ability to live in the light. And so when they fell in and died, then they broke apart, but the bacteria that lived inside that couldn't handle the light could have grabbed their DNA, the plasmid that actually allowed them to live in the light, making them so they could live in the light. So that process is called transformation. But you could have described it if you didn't say the word. I'm okay with that. And then you could have said that they went through asexual reproduction afterwards so that the population was able to survive. That's really what they're looking for, is transformation and asexual reproduction. But it actually says here, then, because there are so many bacteria, the bacteria must have participated in conjugation. I don't think the second one, I would take asexual reproduction or conjugation, either answer. You had to have transformation in there or describe that it got it from the dead guy. Okay? And then from there, you had to have one of the other two. You had to have either asexual reproduction or conjugation. Their answer requires conjugation. I don't think so. We've learned that bacteria in 20 minutes have a generation, and they can go crazy really fast. So I don't think they had to conjugate. I think asexual reproduction would explain it, too. You can start from two and cover the world. Dun, dun, dun. Anyway, okay. Let's see. So that was a super long one. 15. A bacterium is gram negative and needs light to survive. It lives in a habitat that is completely oxygen free. What phylum and class does it belong to? Well, so what is gram negative phylum?
Gracilicutes.
Okay, Gracilicutes, and it has an oxygen free environment, but it's photosynthetic. Who is it? Anoxyphotobacteria. There you go. Good job. So there were two parts to that answer. And number six, so you could have gotten half off, okay? Number 16, a Staphylococcus bacterium is gram-positive and lives in an oxygen-free habitat. To what phylum and class does it belong? All right, so it's gram-positive. Which phylum is that?
Firmicutes.
And it tells us it's a Staphylococcus. So what class does it belong to?
Firmibacteria.
So we didn't really need to know that it was oxygen-free habitat, did we? He did that just to confuse us. Whoa, okay. Let's see. So each answer... Oh, boy. Hang on. 16, 17, 18. He's got each answer as worth 4 points. But that means on 15, each answer is worth 4 points. On 16, each answer is worth 4 points. On 14, each answer is worth 4 points, because there were two on each of those. Okay? So if you do that, then all of them are worth 4 points. Okay? Each answer. All right. And remember, always subtract from 100. Don't add. Subtract from 100.